When you beat the Georgia Bulldogs, you're gonna feel a bulldog.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming to you live from the One Piece Tour Bus at the University of Georgia, it's College Weekly Live with Jack Carpenter. Tonight, the world debut of the Remix to Ignition, the College Edition. I'm Greg Serene, and now, it's your host, Jack Carpenter!
Thank you, everybody. Thank you for coming. Thank you for watching. And welcome to College Weekly Live. We are coming to you from the University of Georgia. Yeah! Now, we've only been in Athens for a few days, so we don't know everything, but we do know these three things. One, the orbit bus at night should probably just be called the grind train. Two, nobody has ever left Topper as a better man than they walked in. And three, I think we're all ready for this weekend to come so we can beat the cocks at home. Let's go! Yeah! Beat the cocks! Woo! Oh, man, Greg, tell me you're ready to beat the cocks.
I live to beat the cocks.
Oh, that's gross. As you know, we are coming to you from the University of Georgia, home of the Bulldogs and 35,197 students. Did you know UGA was founded in 1785, which is almost 10 years later than America was founded, making it the oldest public university in the country? Greg, how cool was this school?
Go Dogs, baby! Stick 'em, dogs! Dogs on top!
Yeah, go Dogs. That's what he's trying to say. Actually, the Bulldogs are doing very well right now. They're 2-0. Perfect, but they have a big matchup this weekend against the University of South Carolina Gamecocks, and it's a great rivalry. It's going to be a great match because Georgia's been beating the Cocks for many, many years now. In fact, the first time Georgia ever beat the Cocks was in 1894.
That's incredible, Jack. They've been beating their Cocks for a long time. I mean, for that long, you wonder how anything else gets done around here, am I right?
I don't know, Greg, but what I do know is that Athens, Georgia is one of my favorite cities. It's so cool. Beautiful campus, great downtown, awesome food, and above all, it has really, really good looking dogs. Beautiful canines everywhere. They're super friendly, so many of them. And maybe because Georgia's mascot is a dog, I don't know, but I'm not gonna complain. I love dogs.
There's some fine looking bitches.
Exactly. Oh, how did I even forget this? Most important of all, Athens, Georgia has the most bars per capita in the United States of America. Yeah! 80 bars. Can you believe that? 80 bars in 1 square mile in Athens, Georgia. I haven't seen that many options to watch the Cocks get beat since Chat Roulette.
Yeah, sex, I get it.
Speaking of beating the Cocks, Georgia was actually just ranked the #1 kinkiest school in America, and I'm kind of curious to find out why.
Don't you have a girlfriend?
Yes, I do, and that's why we sent out our very own field reporter, Kyle, to do the dirty work and find out why UGA is so damn kinky. Kyle?
Yes. No, I will not be having sex with anyone, Jack.
Kyle, nobody told you that.
Okay, just making sure. Well, as you can see, I'm standing in front of the University of Georgia Sanford Stadium, and we're going to be asking students, alumni, and all Bulldogs alike just how kinky this campus is. Come on, let's check out this doggy style. Hey, can I ask you guys a couple questions? She's on the phone.
Sure.
Cool.
Okay, we'll see you
Hang
there.
Up. We just got here, found a lot about this campus, a lot about the school. Okay, so we're out here. At Georgia, Athens, love this place. I don't know if you know this or not, but Georgia was just ranked the #1 kinkiest school in the nation.
Ew. Kinky.
Kinkiest, with a K. Kinkiest meaning having to do with unusual patterns of sexual activity.
I actually read about that. I read about it.
I saw that online, yeah.
I don't think that's true. I've never heard this.
That's false?
Kinkiest?
Kinkiest, have you heard that?
I mean, the girls are... You know.
Honestly, I really don't know that I've heard that, but I could see how that would be, like, true.
That's an honest opinion, and that's a fact, because that's how it is. We do a doggy style around here.
Do you like doggy style?
Can't tell.
Georgia was just ranked the #1 kinkiest school in the nation. What do you think about that?
Y'all are crazy. Get out of here with that. Get out of here.
Is that kind of something you take pride in?
I mean, kind of, honestly.
Yeah, I like it. I like kinky, so.
Wait, let's put it this way. I'm a married man,
And my wife is standing right there, who is 7 months pregnant, and I'm not going to make any more further comments on that.
Absolutely. Smart man. Yeah. Do you have any stories in particular? Or, like, what, like, why do you think that's
any
well
I could share in front of a camera? Back.
What's the kinkiest thing you've ever done? Are you guys kinky? Like, what's going on?
One time I went to this girl's part. She put a gag in my mouth.
What's the kinkiest thing you've ever done?
All right, this girl asked me to choke her, and I was just like, not about it, but like, I mean, I guess it happened.
Yeah.
That's kinky as f***. This one right here, she hit me so damn hard in the side, I got a f***ing scar.
Gonna plead the fifth.
I'm innocent.
I'm gonna go with a no comment on that one.
Nope. I can be kinky, yes.
Do you have any PG stories?
No, they're all rated R.
Kinky is awesome. It's good to be kinky. Everyone likes a kinky person.
I completely agree, man. Hell we should hang out later.
Yeah, dude.
What about that statement, like, a lady in the streets but a freak in the sheets?
That's good. That's good.
But you shouldn't be, like, a freak on the streets. That's bad.
That is bad.
We'll be right back with more College Weekly Live.
You got $100 bill, get your hands up. You got $50 bill, get your hands up. If you got a fat ass, get your hands up.
Gustav here told me you were curious of my life's achievements. Well, it's quite simple, really. I just began to ponder. Ponder is a new social discovery application. It has a clever little algorithm where if your content is praised, you will be discovered and then amass an audience of global proportions.
The people desire a leader. Give them what they want.
Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for watching College Weekly Live. And now, Greg, did you hear the news?
What?
The news.
What news?
Dude, the news.
What f***ing news, Jack?
Jeez, Greg, did you not read the Twitter? R. Kelly just announced that he's returning to college right here at the University of Georgia.
Wait, for real?
No, dude, he can't come back to college. There's girls under 18 here. But we did make a parody about it, and I'm very excited for you guys to see it. So, without further ado, I would like to introduce our first song parody of the season. Greg, take it away.
Thanks, Jack. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time in the history of ever, College Weekly Live presents the remix to Ignition, the College Edition.
Mama told me to be rude. Have I told you I love you? No, this might sound funny, but I need a little bit more money. This the last time and that's the truth. Just try to eat the healthy kale juice. Been up late doing yoga, cause that's how we do it with cats in a toga. Turn down for,
don't know,
there's a party,
let's go.
College in 2014, spending more time than I need, browsing my Facebook feed. It's the remix to Ignition, yeah, the College Edition. Ramen noodles, lunch and dinner, can't afford my tuition. Sipping on super cheap rum, tweeting out I'm so drunk. It's a 3-day weekend, baby, I'm about to make some mistakes. Mistakes, 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 mistakes. First stop, it's the pregame, or what I call it, the pre-shame, where it's my confidence I regain, to talk to the ladies that I'm feeling, playing beer pong to show off my stuff, blame it on not being drunk enough, playing heavy rap to make me look tough. Oh, now I'm a DJ like my fan, now we dancing
tango,
where the girls are
angles.
Now the dancing gets heavy, I'm uncontrollably sweaty, but did we hook up, you bet it. It's the remix to Ignition, yeah, the College Edition. Ramen noodles, lunch and dinner, can't afford my tuition. Sipping on super cheap rum, tweeting out I'm so drunk. It's a 3-day weekend, baby, I'm about to make some mistakes.
World soda poppin' and my friends Honda Civic, then your vines head to toe. If you want the specifics, I got my bros to my left, the lightweight on the right, and one designated driver who'll be grumpy all night. Cause after the pregame, it's the house party, and after we're rejected, it's the next house party. Round about 3, it's my drunk food hobby. Then you take it to your dorm, and you puke in the lobby.
We callin' while browsing Netflix. I'm in my own bed, I made it. I'm 50 shades of faded. My girl arrives via rollerblade.
plan. It's the remix to Ignition. Yeah, the college edition. Ramen noodles, lunch and dinner. Can't afford my tuition. Sipping on super cheap rum. Tweeting out I'm so drunk. It's a 3-day weekend, baby. I'm about to make some mistakes. It's the remix to Ignition. Yeah, the college edition. Ramen noodles, lunch and dinner. Can't afford my tuition. Sipping on super cheap rum. Tweeting out I'm so drunk. It's a 3-day weekend, baby. I'm about to make some mistakes. Mistakes, 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 mistakes. Waking up in the morning, in my head there's pain. Who's this girl next to me? I wish we had roleplay. At least I know I am home. Do you think that we bond? But more importantly, where the hell is my phone?
That's all from Georgia. Next week, Florida State University. Signing off from College Weekly Live. See you next time. I love you.